One of the common threads throughout the entirety of human history is that as time ticks on, life expectancy for the human race has increased. There's been a couple dips here and there thanks to wars or, you know, plagues, but those don't last very long. It typically only affects the one generation and then we move on. But right now, we are actually facing a catastrophe that has the potential to significantly reduce, almost permanently reduce, the life expectancy for human beings on this planet. And that emergency is climate change. And that's not me just speculating here. That's not me trying to scare people into action. That's actually the conclusion of several doctors who recently published these findings in the New England Journal of Medicine, detailing the ways in which climate change is actually going to shorten the lifespan of human beings. In essence, climate change is going to put us all in an early grave. And here's why. This is what these doctors had to say. First and foremost, you have malnutrition that will become rampant as the climate continues to heat up. Crop yields are going to be fewer. We're not going to have as much food to go around. There's going to be less arable land to grow that food, and that's where problems emerge. There won't be enough food to go around. So not only could people potentially die of things like starvation, but you're also looking at a situation where people would not get the proper nutrition that they need to live a long and healthy life. Second thing, and this is probably one of the biggest that's been talked about a lot, is infectious and microbial diseases. Those increase as temperatures increase. I mean, why do you think we have all these tropical diseases and all these horrible things that happen typically around the equator of the United States? It's the warmest part. It's the perfect breeding ground for bacteria and viruses and other microbial diseases. And that area where it's perfect for those things to grow is going to expand the warmer the climate gets. Chronic conditions from more pollution, asthma, heart disease, things like that. And heat exposure, just the simple fact that it's going to be hotter and you could die from heat exhaustion, heat stroke, or anything like that. None of these deaths that they're talking about include deaths that are going to increase from strong hurricanes, from mudslides, from floods, from droughts, and from wildfires. But they're estimating right now that between the years 2030 and 2050, we could see an additional 250,000 human beings across the planet die. And every one of those 250,000 deaths can be attributed to climate change. That is what they're predicting right now. It's not too late, right? We still have some time. We don't have a lot, but there is some time left. We could do something about it. We could change the way things are operating. But unfortunately, we as a country here have an administration that denies that the problem even exists. We have a political party, the Republicans, who have made it part of their party's platform, basically, that climate change isn't real, or if it is, we can't do anything about it. If we can get rid of them, get rid of that way of thinking, then maybe we will have enough time left to act with the rest of the world to prevent these additional deaths and the shortened lifespan of every human being on this planet. I'd say that's worth it.